In today's discussion, we're delving into the recent events surrounding Harry and Meghan Markle, a topic that has captured widespread attention. It's hard to fathom how two individuals could seemingly be unaware of the impact of their actions. Their approach often appears illogical, lacking in reasoning, and oblivious to the principle of action and reaction. The more they face setbacks, the more they persist in their approach, akin to a never-ending loop reminiscent of Groundhog Day, without learning from past errors. There's ongoing speculation about whether Meghan influences Harry significantly or if this side of Harry has always existed, hidden from public view. Some argue that the Harry we witness today is the true version, previously shielded by his family and friends who thought the world wasn't ready for this side of him. Yet, Harry's past actions, especially his involvement with the charity Wellchild, paint a different picture. A former director of the charity recalls Harry's natural affinity for the role, reminiscent of his mother's compassion. He interacted with the children effortlessly, showing genuine care and empathy, not just for the kids but for their parents too. Such behavior, according to the charity, seems spontaneous and sincere. However, it's also known that Harry has had his share of temper issues and moments of questionable behavior, including incidents involving his polo ponies. This complex picture makes it hard to reconcile with the person Chelsea, his former partner, knew. She stayed with him for a considerable time, which leads some to believe that Meghan might have influenced the changes in Harry's personality. In summary, the narrative around Harry and Meghan is one of complexity and contradiction, with past and present behaviors painting a multifaceted picture of their characters. Let's explore the transformation we're witnessing in Harry, which some attribute to Meghan's influence. The belief is that Meghan has fed Harry a series of half-truths, leading to a significant change in his behavior. This has given rise to the theory that their relationship is one of control, where Meghan supposedly holds the reins. Now, let's not overlook the circumstances under which Harry and Meghan met. Harry was reportedly feeling isolated and lonely, finding himself often as the third wheel next to William and Catherine. Most of his friends were married, and being single in his 30s made finding a partner who could adapt to royal life even more challenging. Harry's fascination with Meghan, it seems, began with her character, Rachel Zane, on the TV show Suits. He was drawn to her intelligence and charm. His interest in Meghan was known among his circles, leading to their eventual meeting, which some suggest was orchestrated given Meghan's alleged interest in marrying a wealthy Englishman. However, the reality of Meghan diverged from her TV persona, according to a narrative shared by Harry with a friend during their stay at Tyler Perry's home. Post-marriage, he reportedly felt Meghan had changed, revealing a different side than the one he fell in love with. The question that arises is whether Meghan has an undue influence over Harry. There are claims that she uses emotional manipulation, making Harry feel unwanted and unloved by others, and portraying herself as his sole supporter. Observers note how Harry appears physically reliant on Meghan, often seen with her hand on his arm or back. Finally, the impact of Harry's estrangement from the royal family cannot be understated. This alienation, allegedly driven by Meghan, has had a profound effect on his relationships and behavior, adding another layer to the complex dynamics of their relationship. Let's dive deeper into the current state of Harry's life, which some believe has been heavily influenced by Meghan. It's said that Meghan has isolated Harry from his friends and family, leaving him to depend solely on her. This isolation has reportedly left Harry without a traditional support network, the kind of enduring friendships that withstand life's ups and downs, which he enjoyed before Meghan's arrival in his life. Amidst these changes, there are whispers about Marcus Anderson possibly living with Meghan and Harry residing elsewhere. Their financial situation is also a topic of speculation, with no apparent job offers or solid prospects on the horizon, except for occasional media pieces aimed at keeping Meghan in the public eye. Despite the tumultuous past few years, Harry remains with Meghan. Observers note moments when the old Harry seems to resurface, hinting at his underlying resilience. Ingrid Seward, editor-in-chief of Majesty magazine, recalls Princess Diana describing Harry as the lively and artistic one, capable of handling anything. Diana even playfully dubbed him Good King Harry, possibly fueling some sibling rivalry. However, it's believed that Harry's inherent strength will eventually help him navigate his current challenges. Though the journey may leave him changed, many hold on to the hope that he can learn and grow from these experiences. The key, according to this narrative, is for Harry to step away from his current situation and start anew, but this first step is yet to be taken. As we continue to observe the unfolding saga of Harry and Meghan, the future seems uncertain. Despite efforts by WME over 7 months, there's been no significant breakthrough in improving Meghan's fortunes. However, the possibility remains that she might find a way to turn things around. Many perceive Meghan's actions as manipulative, particularly towards the monarchy, with Harry seemingly outmatched in this dynamic. His upbringing within the royal family and the protection it afforded might have left him unprepared for encounters with individuals like Meghan, who some view as predatory. The path forward for Harry involves a crucial decision. He could either seek guidance from his longtime friends and embrace the tough love his family offers, or continue on a path that diverges from his true self. Observers often note that Harry appears more at ease and liberated when he's away from Meghan, suggesting a need for a change in his current trajectory. The discussion often circles back to the notion of responsibility and apology. There's a sentiment that Harry owes apologies to his family, in remembrance of his grandparents, and to the public he once served. People typically make mistakes in their youth, as illustrated by an anecdote about a judge who, during a jury selection, urged potential jurors to confess to being young and dumb to expedite the process. This raises the question of whether Harry can be afforded the leniency typically given to youthful indiscretions. Some argue that he's beyond the age where such excuses hold weight. The consensus among these viewpoints is that Harry needs to acknowledge his mistakes, seek forgiveness, and embark on a path of personal redemption. The journey ahead for Harry is undoubtedly a challenging one. It's a path that requires not only hard work, but also a deep sense of honesty. Many believe that if he stays committed to these values, he could eventually find his way back into the favorable regard of his family. Turning the conversation to you, the audience, what are your thoughts on Harry's situation? Your opinions and perspectives are valuable, and I encourage you to share them. If you found our discussion insightful, feel free to share it with others who might also be interested. As always, thank you for tuning in and engaging with the topic. Your participation in these conversations is greatly appreciated. Let's continue to explore and discuss these intriguing subjects together.